Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. So I'm like, I have a presentation. This is my first presentation I've had to do at work in front of the whole company today. I've already practiced a couple of times, like before I, you know, turned on this camera, but I don't know. I'm like kind of excited, kind of nervous. I don't know. How do you guys feel about doing, like, you know, big presentations in front of like a large amount of people, or public speaking in general? I feel like with, you know, COVID and Zoom, you just don't really do that as often anymore. And it's such a good skill to have, to be able to, you know, speak in front of people so fluidly and everything. And, you know, I think I'm like pretty good at it. I wouldn't say I'm like the best, and I definitely still get nervous. Like I'm a little nervous about it today, but you know, like I just feel like it's something that like you just need to know how to do. This car chat will probably be short because all I'm like thinking about right now is like my presentation, my talking points and everything. But I think there is like some level of pressure that you just like, I put on myself at least, that I just want to make sure that like I go up there and it's just like engaging for people. Sometimes you like listen to presentations and they're just so boring, but the information that they're talking about is so like important. And I just want, like, you know, when someone's listening to my presentation, I think the presentation I'm going to be talking about, which is a lot about, you know, product development, and we've set department objectives for the year, so kind of listing out what our department objectives are and then how we plan on, like, you know, executing it. So I think it's really important, and I love the fact that the company does this, so like you could just know every department's objectives for the year. But I don't know, I just like want my presentation to be good. And I also just, you know, just public speaking is always so nerve-wracking, and I don't even know like why, you know, we feel like it's so nerve-wracking, like, you know, going up there and just like talking, you know, like I'm talking to myself in the car right now and I can do that so easily, but you put like 30 people in front of me and it's like, oh my gosh, like it's just, you just don't want to say the wrong thing, you just don't want to fumble on your words. But I think I have like such tunnel vision when I'm like up there and I'm like laser focused on, like, you know, hitting my talking points, and I just want to make sure that I'm remembering to do, like, you know, making this as like entertaining as possible, you know, smiling, not talking too fast. I've definitely had people, they say that like, slow down, like you're talking way too fast. And I think I talk really fast when I get nervous, and so I don't know, I just need to like remember just to like, just, I don't know, just like have fun with it. And it's weird because I really like all the people in my office. Like, I don't feel like that scared about like any of them. But I mean, you know, you're talking in front of the CEO, you're talking in front of like all the leadership teams, like the SVPs and everything, so there's a lot, like, you know, you are like, at the end of the day, you are still trying to make a good impression. But you're also just trying to make it engaging and like fun. I would like to know if any of you guys have any tips on, you know, public speaking. Like, what do you do to like get yourself, like prepare yourself as much as possible? Like, I need to have the PowerPoint. I need to like write a script out, almost like all my talking points. And then like, I need to be able to practice like vocally speaking to it. Like, that's why I really like, you know, my commute to work in this sense, because for the past like 30 minutes, I've literally just been like talking my speech out loud, because talking it out loud is so different than, like, you know, in your head, because that's when you start to see, like, you know, you're stumbling on your words, you're saying too many ums. I will say COVID's made it difficult to do presentations for me, because when I was doing presentations during COVID, I would literally just have my script on the side of my Zoom. I would just be speaking my, like, my script. Like, I didn't really have to, like, you know, like, have it in my head, and nobody could tell that I was just, like, reading off of a script. Does that make sense? Like, because when you're up there in front of people, you don't want to be reading on a script. You want to, you know, like, be making eye contact. You want to be, like, you know, moving your hands, you know, be engaged, you know, showing that you are like an expert and you just like know this stuff on the top of your head. Is this even like warranted a car chat? But I mean, this is like my everyday, and these are like things that like I know I'm not the only person to like go through, you know, doing presentations, having these feelings and everything. I'm gonna end this because I really want to like again, would love any advice or any, like, you know, any tips on public speaking. It's been so long since I've done this in front of such a big crowd, so I don't feel like I'm acting nervous, but inside, like, I definitely have the butterflies. But yeah, so that's it for my video. Thank you guys again so much. I'll talk to you guys in my next video. Bye. Hi guys, I just got off work and just wanted to come on here and just give an update that my presentation went really well. I got a lot of good feedback from it. And actually, maybe I should start driving. But actually, when I was like doing the presentation, I feel like I wasn't like as nervous. I don't know. I feel like sometimes like, the nerves and the anticipation of like a presentation like almost get the best of you, but then when you actually like are up there, it's like not really that bad. I guess maybe encouraging anyone who also has to do a presentation soon, it's gonna be Dover, it's gonna be great, you're gonna be a smash hit. Yes. Okay. Okay, bye.